Hi, and welcome to this demo of Agentspace. When you first sign into your Agentspace, the first thing you may notice is that the platform has a very familiar look and feel, and that is because it is laid out very similarly to the Gemini conversation app. Because of this, learning how to navigate and use the features in Agentspace is very intuitive and easy to learn. Now let's get started by taking a look at my Agentspace. In the center, you'll see the familiar dialog box that I can use to access and interact with Gemini anytime I need to conduct research, gather information, ask questions, anything I need from the AI. That tool is still available to me and it works great. Next, you'll notice I have a number of buttons and icons and tools that are available to me. I have a mixture of native Google tools such as shared drives. You can see that I have my recently opened drive files there. I also have my Google Calendar connected, so you can see that I've got an event coming up and quick access to my calendar when I need it. I also have a number of shortcuts that are non-native to Google, such as Confluence, JIRA, Slack, and Salesforce. And my agents will be able to access information and carry out tasks across all these systems. And this can be configured in a number of different ways. Your IT teams can push out the connectors and the tools that your employees need. They can even do things like push out announcements and notifications. You can see here I have a t-shirt pickup notification on my Agentspace. If you expand the menu on the left, you'll have access to additional tools. You can start up a new conversation when you need to. You'll have access to an agent section where you can design, build, and deploy agents. The prompting section gives you some quick prompting tools. The people section is where you can hook up your directory and find the people that you need when you need them. And the NotebookLM section gives you access to your personal research assistant. Down here, you'll find a history of your previous conversations, so you can pick up a conversation anywhere you left off at any time. Now I'm going to take you over a workflow featuring a fictitious company we've created. The company is called Perfect Robotics, which is a company that produces robot vacuum cleaners that also entertains cats. All right, so let's start things off with asking Agentspace to get me any messages regarding vacuum issues in the past 2 weeks. And I can see here that a couple of them are coming up. All right, I want to go ahead and tackle this first one. So I'm going to ask Agentspace to extract the message from the first email for me. There it is. I see the message here. Hi, Mark. Hope you're having a good week. I'm writing about the 25 robot vacuums we purchased. There's the order number. We've had some feedback from our teams that the dust bags seem to be wearing out quicker than expected. Okay. That's something I've got to address. So I'm going to go ahead and just copy that. And I know that I want to get back to this customer as soon as possible. So I'm going to actually access one of the agents I have built just for this. This is an agent that I built. I put the instructions in there telling the agent how to respond to these sorts of things. It's called my customer service agent. So I'm simply going to say, reply to this customer. So here's the original message that I just copied. I'm asking it to build out a reply for me. Let's see what it does. I see the subject that it's put in there. It's appropriate. It's got the order number. So I'm going to go ahead and read through this, make sure everything's okay. There should be a section here. Yes, it is also connected to my Google Calendar. So it's found some dates that I'm available next week and offering those dates where customer and I can meet over a call and try and troubleshoot. I can simply finish it up, personalize it if I need to, and then send that off right away. So now that I've responded to the customer, my next step is I would like to do a little bit of deeper research to try and see if I can understand why this happened, see if there's any patterns I can uncover about those vacuum bags. So I'm going to use one of Google's pre-made agents, which is the deep research agent. So I'm going to go ahead and access this agent and prompt it to analyze customer sentiment and identify common pain points related to dust bags for robot vacuum cleaners from articles, studies, chat forums, social media posts, review sites, etc., and look for mentions of capacity, ease of replacement, durability, allergen filtration, and cost. So the first thing the deep research agent is designed to do is put together a research plan. So based off the prompt, it's actually going to formulate its own plan. You can see here are the steps that it's going to go through. Understanding robot vacuum dust bags, identifying key performance indicators. It's going to go ahead and go through all of these sources. This is its plan. So I'm going to go ahead and start off that research. So we'll let that run for a moment and we'll be right back. And we are back, and Agentspace has produced a thorough report helping me to understand the patterns around dust bags in the vacuum industry and customer sentiment. I'm going to go ahead and follow up. Maybe I want a little bit more information. So I'm asking for any recurring themes around the frequency of dust bag replacements like customers are experiencing, saying, yes, there are clear and recurring themes. Here's a summary of what it's found, customer expectations, recurring pain points. And this has really helped me gain a much better understanding of users' experiences. So up next, let's talk about custom agents. Custom agents can be designed and built in Vertex AI, then pushed out to your employees' agent spaces. They can be configured in a variety of different ways, and this particular agent has the ability to search through Reddit via the Reddit API, and it can also search through inventory data that's located in our BigQuery. In addition to that, it can also help me submit orders. Let's take a closer look. So I'd like to know what Redditors are posting about vacuum bags today, and which subreddits are popular. And it looks like there are several subreddits with interesting posts. I'd like to take a closer look at the robot vacuum subreddits. What are the top posts there? All right, that's a lot of really interesting information. Next, I'd like to get a list of vendors that I typically order from. I do remember some of these vendors. Let's focus in on TurboVac Inc. I've used them before, but don't remember what I've purchased. What do they sell again? That's right, they sell the Dust Bag XL pack. Do I have any orders from them currently? Okay, it looks like I do. All right, I'd like to order more. Can you create an order for 4 Dust Bag XL packs from TornadoVac? Excellent. My order for 4 Dust Bag XL packs from TornadoVac has been placed, and there is my order number. Fantastic. So placing that vacuum bag order was very simple because of our custom agent. However, if I wanted to find a place with information about procedures on how to place orders, I might look to something like a notebook. NotebookLM is built right into your agent space. Because NotebookLM allows you to research vast amounts of information based on sources that you provide, it is the perfect place to hold a repository of knowledge like instructions for how to place orders. Let's take a look at our TornadoVac ordering procedure notebook. This notebook contains information on the ordering procedures for TornadoVac. Instead of searching through the instructions, I can simply ask for what I'm looking for. It looks like there are actually two ways to place an order through TornadoVac. That's using their TornadoVac vendor portal or via the custom agent that we just did. Another question I might ask is, if I place an order through the agent, how does it handle insufficient stock? It looks like when there is an insufficient stock, the agent proceeds with an external order process. If I want to know more, I can always inspect the sources themselves. Finally, let's ask it what information I need before placing an order through the agent. It looks like before placing an order, this is the information that I'll need. To recap, I was able to use AgentSpace to identify a customer issue and respond to them quickly. Then I conducted deep research on robot vacuum dust bags to understand customer sentiment about the issue. Next, I used our custom agent to query Reddit to check out the latest trending posts on vacuums. I use the same custom agent to check out my order history and then place a new order. And finally, I use NotebookLM to understand the ordering procedures our company has in place. Thank you for watching this Agentspace demo. We'll see you next time.